In the 1964 film Dr. Strangelove by Stanley Kubrick, this file title appears as an instructional document for military top brass and political operatives. It is a satirical exaggeration, a comical alliteration of a detached management speak, infecting every corner of life and a death. This film arrived on the eve of the 1960s cultural and political revolution, when all previous social and moral forms and norms were under attack as never before. It is an archetype for what came next. The director, Stanley Kubrick, chose his targets carefully. The progenitors of the nuclear chaos that engulf this story are an alpha white male whose sexual potency has abandoned him, and a deranged and unrepentant Nazi scientist, the eponymous Strangelove. The Soviets are merely the hapless victims of this accidental, occidental madness, the authoritarian personalities driven insane in their WASP Nazi imperium. And the maddest of the mad, he who rides the nuclear device like a bucking bronco at a rodeo, that's Major Kong, the archetypal southern redneck steeped in ignorant whiteness to the tips of his pointy cowboy boots. All the jigsaw pieces are here in this film to put together the anti-white, anti-Christian, anti-male, anti-everything counter-culture that has tormented us ever since. But one cannot deny the brilliance of this work, the gifted and practiced application of its art, wonderfully conceived and executed by a man of great talent. And in its wild and satirical musings, there are insights and truths beyond the mere polemic, that history is made in fire, in the application of great power, in death and destruction. In the futuristic subterranean war room, men meet and plot your future, and whether indeed you will have one at all. The Angel of Death is a military bureaucrat reading a file composed by a faceless technocrat. For we, stripped of our timeless moral agency and sovereignty, are now best managed and controlled by experts, doctors, doctors of everything, doctors of death. It all seems so terribly close.